Gitflow is an alternative branching model that starts with a standard Git repository. Instead of collaborators creating and merging feature branches directly from main, Gitflow introduces a secondary, longer-lived development branch that lives alongside the main branch. Collaborators branch from dev and merge back when their feature is complete. This means each commit on the development branch typically represents one entire complete feature. Once enough individual features have been completed, they can be bundled up and merged into the main branch at the same time. However, doing this doesn't mean merging the dev branch directly into main. Merging multiple new features at the same time introduces a higher risk of merge conflicts and requires additional collaboration. To account for this, Gitflow introduces the idea of release branches. When a team is ready to deploy, a release branch is created to start the release cycle. These release branches essentially snapshot the dev branch at a certain point in time and allow testing, bug fixes, and other release-oriented tasks to be encapsulated within that branch. Other feature development can continue while the team preps the release. Once ready, that release branch can be merged into main and also back into dev to account for any of those small changes that may have been introduced to facilitate the release specifically. The Gitflow branching model is often employed by teams that operate a waterfall development cycle, meaning longer delivery times between new releases, among other things. In waterfall, each time a release branch is merged into main, that merge commit is typically tagged. These tags correlate to version numbers and contain information about what has changed since the last revision. If you're interested in more information about tagging or how Git is used within the context of a software delivery pipeline, you can find those videos along with other deep dives on learngit.io. Because the Gitflow process is more time-consuming than simply merging feature branches to main, if a bug needs to be addressed quickly, hotfix branches are employed. These hotfix branches are the only branches that should spawn directly from main, and they're meant to address time-sensitive issues. Once a hotfix is complete, it's merged into main as well as dev. And aside from some nuances that I glossed over for the brevity of this video, that's pretty much all there is to understand about Gitflow. But don't be discouraged thinking you need to learn a whole new set of skills. Gitflow is simply a model that describes how to utilize certain techniques you already know. The commands you see on screen to create, checkout, and merge branches are the only commands necessary to do everything we covered in this video. If you're keen to see examples of these actual commands in practice, refer to my video on Applied Gitflow, where we go over all of that. Lastly, there is an extension library called git-flow that encapsulates certain combinations of branching and merging commonly found in Gitflow models. However, the basic branching and merging commands are more than enough to get started without needing to learn git-flow specific syntax.